say if you are doing scuba diving, say go 50 feet, below 45 feet, and you have a cut, you are bleeding white. What color? Red color, right? But you do not see your red blood, because there is no red light over there. That's what I am saying. Allah is saying, each light color will stop up to a certain depth, including after 3,000 feet is complete darkness. There is no light. Even the fish cannot see itself. So Pacific Ocean is 7 miles deep, remember. So we are talking about a few hundred feet. This is about biology. Every living thing is made with 80% water. We are human, we are moving, right? We are 80% water. That is one of the missions NASA has when they send any probe to any planet. One of the missions is to find, is there any water over there? If there is a water, there is a possibility of living things. If there is no water, nothing is there. So those aliens are somewhere. Not those planets so far we have visited. Allah mentioned about it in many places, from water every living thing. Al-Anbiya verse number 20. This is another, Al-Furqan, man from water. This is another place, An-Nur 45. Every moving, living creature from water. Allah has reason to describe the same thing again and again in many places. So scientists can analyze why the sequence, why it is mentioned here, why in this verse, in this location, and they discover many things. But bottom line is, we are made with 80% water. So when you feel bad, you have a lack of water in your system. Drink a lot of fresh water, not Coca-Cola. How about that? This is about botany. Everything made in pairs. Whatever you see, they have pairs. And so we have genetic engineering. This is another place. Ar-Rad, Jawzain is 9, it's a complex word, it means black and white, sweet and sour, swollen, all used for the buzzword, Allah used it here. What it means that you have genetic engineering, you can bisect, dissect, break it up and make a new combination with a better quality. Like good example, 30, 40, 50 years back, Florida is still making a lot of oranges. In the old days, if the weather is bad, all the orange will be lost, frostbite. Not anymore. Now we have orange, they can survive in the frost. We have rice seeds, you can grow in the desert. We have watermelon. If you come to Texas, we have what you call onion, 5 pounds. How about that? They named it IRS Stanford. So those things are possible because Allah put the information over there. You just make a better combination and make a better product. Like good example, there is a company called Monsanto. They developed a rice, very big in size. And that rice can grow in desert. You don't need fertilizer. You don't need any spray, insecticide. It grows everywhere. And India is the largest producer of rice. They want that seed. India and Monsanto say you have to give the right price. There is a war going on in the United Nations. So it is possible to develop a better product because Allah put all the information in pairs. Just to give an idea, we have watermelon here, right? How much is the watermelon here? Who knows? What price?
$5?
You don't have less than $5? Okay? It is, what shape is this?
A round.
Round, right? If you go to Japan, the same watermelon is cost $100. How about that? Because it is cubical in shape. Their refrigerator cannot fit. If you have a circular, it takes more space. They don't have that space. So they designed a different one. So it is possible, like we have grapes, different seeds, without seeds, all kinds of combinations possible, because Allah put all the information there. This is about geology. Bees. This gentleman, he is a French scientist. In 1973, he did research on the behavior and communication of bees and he got Nobel Prize award. And he used many Quranic verses to understand how the bees behave. How 100,000 bees work together. They stay in the same place. We humans constantly fight. We cannot go alone together. Even Muslims, we have a hard time. Countries after countries, we are fighting each other. So there are a lot of things to learn from the bees. Allah mentioned about them in many places. They have a distribution, workers, female, queen, and so on. They work together. Just to give an idea, if you go to a colony, every colony has one queen. What is her job? About 2,000 eggs per day. Lot of eggs. That is her job, continuously delivering eggs. And there are workers who are all female, but their job is to build the nest, make holes, clean, bring food, all these things. Their number is 10 to 50,000. And there are male drone, only very few, 100 to 500. What is their job? Mate and die. The moment you mate, you have to die. So all the dead bees you can see at the bottom, coming from top, they're all dead bees, they're all male bees. So think about human being, if you would be like that, what would happen to us? So that's the beauty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the system that 100,000 bees can live together. They build honey. They bring honey for the benefit of mankind. In fact, Einstein said one very important thing, that if suddenly the bees are all dead on the earth, the whole earth will not survive more than 4 years. Bee has a very important role about the system on the earth. It is so vital for the bees' presence that it can completely wipe out the whole network. This is about ants. They work very hard and they keep on working. Not only that, scientists now say the closest thing to human are the ants. And Allah mentioned in many places references about bees, how they warning each other, about Sulaiman al-Salam when he was traveling. And there are many similarities. They bury their dead body. They have a sophisticated system of division of labor with managers, supervisors, foreman, workers, like we have in a plant. How about that? They meet once in a while among themselves and chat. They work very hard. So, okay, let us have some good time. I tell our kids that if you want to chat, come to the masjid to chat with your friends. Not in the computer. You don't know who is the other guy on the other side. It may be predator. Very dangerous. And they have an advanced method of communication among themselves. They hold regular markets to exchange goods. So beautiful. That was the habit of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Anytime he used to receive any gift, he used to give it away to his companions. Every companion used to think that Prophet loved me most. How about that? In fact, some of the companions, they left after Isha, Salatul Isha, to come at Fajr. They could not wait till Fajr. He used to come in the middle of the night. That Ya Rasulullah, I cannot wait till Fajr. It is too long, too painful for me to separate myself. I have to see you right now. They have so much attachment because they have the habit of exchanging goods. So try to make your habit to exchange goods with someone not from your country, from your language, with someone you don't know, simply because he is a Muslim. That should be our attitude. Exchange goods. Can you be like ants? And they store their grain in winter. They have low profile activity. This is about embryology. It's a very broad-based subject. So inshallah, we'll try to cover as much as we can. This is the DNA. This is the human cells. You all grow all from those cells. Every human being has 100 trillion cells. They are organized into chromosomes, 23 pairs of chromosomes. There are many, many references in the Quran. 23 pairs in the nucleus. And there are many things. About the DNA, what does it mean? Allah put all the genetic information like data bank into the DNA. When you are growing in the mother's soul, what will be the color of your hair? What will be the color of your eye? How high you will be? How much sickness you will have? How many hairs in the right eye group? On the left eye group? Everything was defined into the DNA. If you try to write down everything Allah put into the DNA, it will take 450,000 pages to write everything. Like a big life. No two DNA can ever be same. Modern day criminal investigation can be traced using the DNA. If some crime happens, if you find a hair or anything, you can find that person's identity. This is standard by the police, by the FBI. Like if you touch a door, if you take the fingerprints, you can find that person's identity. Who touched that? This is a very standard. In fact, a lot of cases, somebody was convicted 25-30 years back. There was no DNA at that time. Now they found out through the DNA that the person was innocent. He was wrongfully convicted. Modern day criminal, many medical science are using the DNA for a lot of research, stem cell research, prenatal diagnostics. These are the advancement of science because Allah put all the information into the DNA. Like good example, someone has cancer. Many women has cancer, breast cancer. His or her father had cancer, he has cancer, he or she has cancer, his child will have also cancer. This is genetic, genetically transformed. So it is possible before the child was born, he can remove those cancerous cells and the child will be born cancer. Those kind of research are ongoing right now. Because Allah put all the information into the DNA. And this is the egg, as you can see, there are 3 million actually trying to enter into that egg. Only one will be able to enter. Allah made system in such a way, Allah mentioned, it says the verse number 8, particular word is called sulala, that one will be able to enter, then everything stops, the egg will be fertilized. And that's how we are born, we are grown up. And this is a particular word only in the whole Quran in one place. Al-Zumar, verse number 6. Zulmatus Salasi. 3 veils of darkness. No matter how much Arabic you know, you will not be able to explain this. You have to be a scientist. That's why you have Dr. Keith Moore. As you can see, he actually defined the 3 walls. Allah is saying, what are their names? How they are protecting the fetus in their, with their walls. And how the fluid permeates from one side to the other side and so on. There are a lot of description about the whole thing. In the same way, Allah mentioned about many things. This is one place, Al-Qiyamah. He fashioned everything in due proportions. Your hand, your leg, your eye, everything has certain dimension. And so on. In the same way, there are roughly 200 body cells a human being has, like this. Each of them is different. Each of them has different functions. Heart cell, body cell, bone cell, liver cell, everyone is different. Each knows how to use the information from the DNA and grow. That is the confusion, like a big IT department. This is completely flawless. They collect the information and grow. Each cells grow and multiply. Each part of your body is fully customized. And there is continuous development. This is the heart development. All fluid takes about 40 days to build your heart. Then it starts pumping. That's how the mother realized that she has a baby. Right? And then this is the face development. It takes about 60 days to make your beautiful face. Did you ever look at the mirror and thank Allah that, oh Allah, you made me such a beautiful face? Nobody has this face on the earth. Only I have. It took extra time actually to build your face. You could have done like that. It took extra time to build your face. And this is eye development. And this is blood circulatory development. They're all fluid, eventually there are millions of lines through which blood is flowing from head to the toe. Millions of lines. Now scientists estimate that the total length of the blood vessels is more than 24,000 miles as long as the circumference of the earth. How about that? You're from head to the toe, this little heart is pumping blood to every part of the body. If there is anywhere blood clots, you are useless. Go to the hospital and see how people are suffering. In the same way that chromosomes, mother has XX, 23 pairs, and father has 22 pairs XX, one pair with X and Y. This Y is responsible for the fetus to be a boy. Just see that. That is the father XY, mother is XX. So if the combination is XX, it is a girl. If the combination is XY, it is a boy. It happens right at the inception. Many undeveloped countries, if a mother has 2 girls or 3 girls, everybody starts blaming her. She cannot have children. Matter of ignorance, family breaks down. Abuse, all these things have happened because of ignorance. She is already doing the hard part. She is caring for 9 months. It is the husband's responsibility to deliver wife. If you cannot deliver wife, don't expect a wife. You better do a good job. So this is the system Allah has developed. And embryology, as you can see, Professor Keith Moore, he was given 80 questions about Quran and science. He said everything is correct. And he also said there are many verses in the Quran which he cannot answer because those things have not been discovered yet. We think Quran is a very old book, history book. This scientist is saying it is so advanced. There are many things yet to be discovered. In the same way, a fetus can see and hear. After 24th week, he can hear. After 28th week, he can see. First he hears, then he sees. Allah mentioned in the Quran many places, as you can see. Every place is consistent. First we hear, then we see. First we hear, then we see. And scientists say, yes, that's how it works. First we hear, then we see. It didn't happen by coincidence. So let us conclude ourselves, how to benefit post from Allah. What can you do? We are here for a short life. After 100 years, none of us will be here. This masjid will be here, will be gone. Will be replaced by other people. So what can I do to be most successful, to benefit most from Allah? That should be our focus. First of all, we should think about Allah, that He created everything just by saying a word, kun fayakun. So when you see the universe, you should think about Him. Sometimes NASA discovers many things, we give so much credit. How about the creator of those things? He has 99 names. He can see everything. He can hear everything. He controls my life and death. Everybody celebrates birthday, right? How about the departure day? It's coming. He knows when it will happen. And He cannot go outside His boundary. We don't even know His boundary. We cannot hide from Him. We are at His mercy every moment. If you want to go to the hospital and see how people are suffering, your heart is working, kidney is working, liver is working, every part of your body is functioning so beautifully. Go to the hospital and see how people are suffering for little things. We are drowned in the mercy of Allah. So Allah is doing all these things for me, even if I don't realize. What I should do? First of all, my message is, we should try to understand the Quran. It is not just for reading and counting the words. It's more than that. It is not that the non-Muslim will be discovering everything for us. As a Muslim, we have no idea. Second thing, the purpose is to obey Allah and follow His messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And there is the shaitan in the middle. He is our open enemy, Allah says. He is working 24/7. When you are sleeping, He is working. So, the point is, who wants to get the highest success in the life here? That okay, whatever happens in this world, my income, my job, my profession, whatever I have, my life, everything is limited. Short life. But I want to get the best one here. How can I get the best paradise forever? Who wants that best paradise? Only few guys. Others are sleeping probably. So, I have a job for you. If you really want the best paradise, here is a job for everybody. Man, woman, everybody. Maximize your effort for spreading Islam. Highest paid job, spreading Islam. If you see complete Quran and Hadith, highest reward will be given to those people who are responsible to spread Islam. Like the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They are the smartest people. They took the message seriously. And they delivered. That's why Muslims all over the world. And that should leave your legacy. Because when you die, what you are leaving here? Couple of $1 million, couple of houses. But you should leave your legacy. Like Imam Bukhari, he lived 66 years. He collected 600,000 hadiths. He was always on travel. Even Muslims gave hard time for him. He even took shelter with his student, Imam Muslim. But his mission was to collect hadiths. And in his life, he collected 600,000 hadiths. Out of that, he only selected 4,774 hadiths. That is called Sahih al-Bukhari. That book is so precious, so valuable, that till the last day of this world, no Muslim can learn a hadith without that book. That is his legacy. What is your legacy? When you leave, what will you leave? So these are the approaches we have. You can do easy dawa or difficult dawa. Which one you like? Easy dawa is email. jail. I supply Quran in the jail. If you want to join, you can jail. There are thousands of Muslims in the jail. And all these TV politicians, news reporters, all this are there. One of the effective ways, I have developed a CD. I'll show it to you. This CD, you can give it to anybody, any place, anytime. Many times you have open house, you don't have to wait for open house once in a year. You can carry. I carry hundreds of them, I give it up. Anytime I meet with anybody, just give it up. And it will generate a lot of things. Like you're born here, you're going to die here. If you are a good Muslim, your everything stops after you die. You cannot pray, you cannot fast, you cannot do anything. But if you are involved with the work of Dawah, you can see it will continuously grow, even after you leave. Forever. Unlimited. I can see. Why should I settle for less? You know, people change job for 2%, 1% increase. Why should I not spend little more time to give Dawah? So I have unlimited opportunity. Forever. That should be our focus. So this CD has a presentation from my two books. It's called In English, Spanish, Arabic and French. I present to churches, PowerPoint presentation. What are the things common between different religions? You can use it anywhere, masjid, church, anywhere, any open forum. If you don't have PowerPoint, you can get PDF also, it is there. And what I did, I also have powerful testimonies. I thought the best way to get attention to someone, they only non-Muslim, they only know everything bad about Islam from the media. So how can you counter them? I have some 28 testimonials of famous people. They are famous in the community, but they also became Muslim. What is the reason? I have been MP4 and also audio. You can hear in the car. Right. When you are in the car, you can. It's working for you. Picture is better than 1,000 words. These are the listing. Number one is she was Miss Czechoslovakia. She became very famous, Miss World, and later she became Muslim. What is her story? Just 1 minute. Very short but very powerful. Famous people. CNN TV reporter, British actress, BBC News, American Army commander, Vatican priest. All those samples I collected, just few of them, just to give enough information to the person who is looking to those things or he is hearing. You can give it out to anybody, masjid, church, temple, university, social club, Starbucks. Starbucks I found a very good option because people are relaxed, they spend hours working with their computer, there we can talk to them. We dive into it. Anywhere, any place. No excuse now. So for more information, we have this CD available, we have some copies available, what I presented about Quran and science, and also you can get their CD. We collect some funds to bring more Quran and distribute. So take charge of Islam. You are charged in your office, in your hospital, in your business, you are top of the line. How about taking charge of Islam? I am responsible. I am the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Man, woman, we are all equally responsible. So please take time and do something about it. Whatever life is gone, you cannot get back. Whatever is left, we don't know how long. But make best use of the situation, best use of the present. Especially living in this country. I always say that. This is the richest country in the world. Is it not? Everybody wants to come here. For various things, education, technology, disease, whatever, fashion, you name anything. So the whole world is looking into this country as a model. So while you are living here, you have a good job, good profession, good car, may Allah give barakat in your life. Okay? You don't have to give up anything. But your presence here can make a big difference in spreading Islam. Whatever you will spread from this masjid, it will go to every part of the world. So do not underestimate the power of your masjid. Like the Prophet's masjid, it was very small. When these companions used to pray, they used to get mud on their faces. But that masjid was such a powerful, after 9 years, first one saw we bring a candle. It was dark for the first 9 years. But that masjid had such a powerful light, it went to every part of the world. So I want to have this masjid ICO, Florida, right? I want this masjid to be the masjid of the Prophet. The mission should be spreading Islam to every part of the world. No excuse. We have the technology, we have the means, we have the information. It's just a matter of sharing with others. I continuously share the CD. Sorry, somebody pulled in, I think. Anyway, we are done. Anyway, so we have some CDs, DVDs, books available for them. So whatever you benefit from it, please take time and do something about it. We have been keep thinking forever. How long will we be thinking? Time is running out. So please make best use of your situation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you barakat in your life. Inshallah, we have a table, inshallah, for the books, DVDs. We have some cost. We collect for the dawah purpose. We deliver to the jail free. There are thousands of Muslims in the jail. I have a flyer, I gave it to our doctor, sir. Please post it in the website. Every family can do that. You don't have to buy anything. You just collect from your home and ship it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give barakat in your life and make best use of it. Jazakallah khair.